Choice and Don John at the festival are kind of extreme, kind of off the map choices for you, or do they not seem that way to you?
I'm not sure what's on the map exactly. I don't know. Do they seem off the map?
Well, I mean, have you been looking for something more fulfilling than mainstream Hollywood? I mean, has that been part of the, because you also did theater a couple years ago, and, you know, it seems like you're making choices that are not necessarily conventional movie star choices, I guess.
Yeah, I mean, I think the only, I've been very fortunate to do, to be involved in the Marvel universe for a few years, which I think makes it seem, because those movies are so hugely successful, you know, makes it seem maybe that I've had a little bit more of a mainstream career than I really ever had. But I mean, those are films that I've been super fortunate to be a part of. But most of the time, I think I've worked, I'm used to working in smaller films, in the sense that the crew is smaller, the films are usually kind of independent productions. And so more than really trying to find a film of a specific size or budget, I've in the past couple of years really been able to enjoy doing really wide variety of different types of films and different types of characters. And
have you had a hard time finding interesting stuff? I mean, that's always the complaint, particularly from actresses.
I don't know. It's been a bit of a transitional period for me, as I've kind of transitioned like out of that ingenue phase, but I'm not quite, you know, for a while I was kind of in between being a, you know, young woman and a woman, that kind of, what do you do with, you know, that period. I'm not really a, you know, I've never been attracted to like big popcorn kind of romantic comedies. Mm-hmm. And also I've never been kind of cast in that way. So it's been, I guess, a bit of a challenge just to find the right fit for me. Also, I've been always interested to work on things that were kind of would provide me with some sort of artistic challenge and stretch me a little bit. And so in that respect, it can be a bit of a search, but.
So which came first, Jonathan or the screenplay in this case?
This screenplay for this I read several years ago, and kind of started having a conversation with Jonathan a few years ago about it. And it was initially it was a two-hander, and it was a story that really revolved more around these two characters kind of sort of assimilating into society, and then, you know, kind of not being found out. And then there was a story with like the townspeople and how, you know, they're kind of this discovery of, you know, what was kind of happening to them as they were being like picked off, basically. And then you'd see these, you know, the couple and their kind of relationship with each other was a very, really witnessed like their kind of alien life, as opposed to this film, which is seeing the world kind of through these alien eyes, I think. And as Jonathan, I think, pared down the story, and kind of as the story began to take shape, or as he sort of understood what the essential attraction was for him. You know, I was kind of always checking back in, like, hey, what's happening with that Glazer movie? And, you know, I probably just stalked him until he got sick of hearing from my agent. And, you know, I think eventually we kind of realized that we were having the same conversation. And, you know, I think I wasn't really convinced I could do this until I was convinced that Jonathan was convinced that I could do it, and then.
So was paring it down exciting for you? Was it getting to a better and better place as it was kind of becoming more minimalist?
Yeah, I mean, for me, it was becoming, more of an opportunity for Jonathan and I to be the kind of two-hander in this. Sounded great, and you know, it gave me a better. It allowed me to have a much broader arc. And it was, it was way more attractive to me in the kind of incarnation that you see today.
Scary? Or?
Yeah, it was scary.
Do you like scary as a rule? Do you want to be unsure whether you can actually do the job?
I'd rather be unsure if I can do a job than sure I can do it. I mean, if I'm sure that I mean, I'm sure I could do it, but I mean, right. I'd rather not know what I'm going to do exactly than be so kind of well suited for something that there's nothing really fresh for me to contribute, you know. Mm-hmm.
So you guys continued to work on it to kind of together as you went through the process before you shot?
No, we kind of worked on it as we were shooting it because a lot of the scenes had to kind of find their shape while we were in the middle of doing. I mean, you know, we would know what we needed to get. You know, I knew what my motivation was or where like my end point was. And then I just had to kind of figure out how I was going to get to where I needed to go. And that just took time, I guess, because none of the script is really, I mean, none of what you see in the film is really scripted.
Right. So did you know what it all meant as you were doing everything? Did you always have a clear picture of the subtext, or was that not necessary?
No, not the subtext. I mean, that's all kind of, you know, up to interpretation. You know, I was just clear of what my where my character was at that particular moment in her evolution, and that's all that really mattered to me, as opposed to, you know, what does this mean, and you know, where are the themes, and how does this relate to, you know, what we've seen before, and anything like that. I mean, it was more about being aware of which stage of the development my character was in.
So if you were doing a take, would you do a bunch of takes because it was, you were trying to get something, or were you just exploring together as you did a lot of this stuff? A lot of it's so silent and just you emoting.
We would do probably, I mean, we would spend all day shooting one scene just to try to, especially, I'm speaking specifically about the scenes that involve other actors or, you know, other performers. It was, we would start out with the scripted scene, but then I don't even know why we ever bothered to do that, because it was so obvious that Jonathan would just hate it and it wasn't real and it didn't feel right and it was fake. And then, you know, we'd have to kind of break the scene down so much that, you know, all of our kind of, whatever like judgment we placed on ourselves or any preconceived ideas we had were just, gone, and we could just be very like present, I guess.
So were you surprised when you finally saw it all together?
I don't know if surprised is the right word, but I was definitely overwhelmed, I think, when I first saw it, just because it's so personal and it's such an intimate portrait of that character that I felt very exposed, I guess, when I saw it. It's like, whoa, you know, this kind of like, wow, that really, we really did that, and people are really gonna see it, you know. And like Jonathan says, he's like, I wish I could just put it under a tree and burn it. I'm like, don't tell people that. That's gonna be the end of the interview if you say that.
And indeed, it's the end of the interview. Timing works that way. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.
Back upstairs.
Thank you. Pleasure.